Are you feeling insecure that someone will copy your CSS code? Don't worry. In this video, I'm gonna give you not only one method, I'm gonna give you four methods with the help of which you can secure or hide your CSS code. And at the end of this video, I'm gonna give you one method with the help of which you can just protect your both CSS and JavaScript code. Hello everyone, this is Itzaru with CodingDesign. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I'm in my HTML document. I have already linked my CSS file. If you want to see my CSS code, this is my CSS code. And also this is my JavaScript code. Now let's go back to the browser. If you view the page source, and now if you click that linked CSS file, you can see this CSS code, which is in readable format and which is really easy to figure it out. And same goes for the JavaScript file. It's time to protect our CSS and JavaScript code. Method number 4, obfuscate or modify CSS code. You can use this one online tool, CSS Obfuscator. If you visit cssobfuscator.com, this website will modify your CSS code. So now let's go back to the code editor. Let's copy our CSS code and paste it there. Press that green button. After a few seconds, you'll get your modified version of CSS code. Now let's copy this code and go back to the text editor. Create new file. I'm naming it as custom.css. Paste the copied code there. Let's save the file. Go back to the HTML document. Let's change its linked CSS file to custom.css. Go back to the browser, hit refresh, view the page source. And if you view that CSS file, now you can see it is really difficult to figure it out, like what's going on. So this is the first method with the help of which at least you can like give a tough time to figure it out. Let's go back to the code editor. Similarly, you can minify your CSS code. If you are using Visual Studio Code like me, you can right click and hit that minify document option. So if you are not getting that option, you have to install the extension called JS and CSS minifier. If you install this extension, you'll be able to minify any JavaScript as well as CSS code. So in the CSS file, if I right click and hit that minify document option, it will automatically generate the minified version of CSS code. You can see that. This minified version of CSS code can be easily unminified. We don't need this file, so I am deleting this file. Method number 3, use CSS at import rule. To keep original CSS code safely for the future use, I am creating a new file and naming it as main.css. Now let's go to the style.css file. Let's copy this code and paste it there. Close this main.css file, and in the style.css file, write at import. Let's import the custom.css file. So the file that we have created in the method number 4. Okay. Import the custom.css file. Save the file. Go back to the HTML document. Change the link of CSS file to style.css. Inside the style.css file, we are importing custom.css file. Now if you go to the custom.css file, you can get there the modified version of our original CSS code. Let's go back to the browser, refresh, view the source code. Now if you go to the CSS file, now you can see there is only one line of code, but somebody, like if they manage to get that CSS code, now they won't get that original code. Like they will be getting this modified version of CSS code. Okay. Method number 2, use JavaScript code. Now let's create a link with the help of JavaScript. So in order to create link, I'm writing let link is equal to document.createElement, and we're creating the link element Now let's give the different attribute for the link element. So for the link element, I'm giving link type. For the type, I'm giving text slash CSS. And also let's give link dot relation. So we are giving the relation of style set. And also let's give the href attribute for the link. And in the href, I'm giving the CSS files location. Let me show you. If I go to the browser and hit this location in the address bar, if you hit this file's location, you will get that CSS code. So let's copy that location and let's paste it here. And now let's write document.query selector, and inside the for the selector, I'm giving the head and dot append child. So we're appending the link, so this will automatically create a CSS link. Go back to the HTML document. Let's remove that CSS link and save the file. Go back to the browser, refresh. If you view the source code, you can't see any kind of like link, CSS link. Okay, you'll be able to see only the JavaScript link. Hit that link, you'll get the JavaScript code, but still you can get the CSS files location from this code. If you copy that location and paste it in the address bar, now still you can get the CSS code. So now you need to modify the JavaScript code too. Method number one, obfuscate or modify JS code. In order to modify the JavaScript code, you need to first of all copy the JavaScript code. Okay, before doing that, let me show you one website. If you visit this beautifytools.com, in this website you will get the bunch of tools with the help of which like it makes you, I think, like the coding life much more easier, you know, like there are lots of tools you can see. So I'll search one tool like Java, yeah, this JavaScript obfuscator. So you can copy this whole JavaScript code and paste it there. And also you can look at that, you can select the options, different options. So I am choosing this numeric and hit that green button, and yeah, it will generate the modified version of your JavaScript code. So now you can copy this code. So let's create custom.js file, and I'm gonna paste it there. Now let's link this custom.js file in HTML document. So instead of script.js file, we are linking custom.js file. Let's go back to the browser, refresh. If you view the source code and if you click that JavaScript link, you'll get this modified version of JavaScript code. And you can look at that, you can get numeric value, you know, that doesn't make any sense. It's really, really difficult to, you know, figure it out, like what's going on with that code. So yeah, in this way you can give a really tough time to figure it. But remember, for the experienced web developer or engineers, they can like figure it out. So nothing is 100% secure. I'm again telling you, nothing is 100% secure. So this is only a one approach. With the help of this long CSS files path, it is easier to figure out the location of CSS file. So it's better to give only CSS files name, that is standard CSS. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also be sure to hit that subscribe button. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.